For myself, I am a professor in medical genetics and elaborative diagnostics, and I present here as a national representative for the 1 million genome project. Here are the overview of my short presentation, starting from some overview. So you may know or may not that in Hungary we have almost 10 million inhabitants, many healthcare providers, but related to genomic medicine, it's very important to highlight that these are centralized at 4 medical schools and my home workplace, the Genetic Oncology. So genomic medicine covers in Hungary mostly the healthcare related to patients with rare diseases and patients with rare cancers. And also, as I said earlier, the medical schools, the universities, and the National Institute of Oncology are dealing with education and research activities related to genomic medicine. Here is the map of Hungary, and you can see that in Budapest, in the central Hungary, Szentendre University, the National Institute of Oncology located, and different regions of Hungary. And it's very important because these universities, the medical schools, are responsible for the healthcare, as a centralized healthcare for these regions. So it's relatively easy to involve them in genetic medicine related healthcare and other activities. In details, I try to summarize our recent activities. I would start with Szentendre University, which is the largest institution in Hungary dealing with genomic medicine. Here is a dedicated institute led by Professor Molnár, who is also actively participating in our national neural group. Basically for genomic medicine and rare diseases, it's the only one institute in Hungary where both inpatient and outpatient personalized patient care is available. Here, it's also available molecular genetic diagnostic, bioinformatic, and also very nice research facilities. I had to mention, because to the 1 million genome project is very focused on cancer, the first department of pathology and experimental cancer research, where is also available a nice genetic facility with many instruments, and they are covering all molecular genetic diagnostics related to somatic cancer. It's very important. We are strong working together with European reference networks. At the Szentendre University, we have 7 full members, and also Szentendre University coordinate it's a national hub for recently accepted EIRs. And my field of interest, the rare endocrine tumors and the genetic tumor syndromes. So I have to mention the the NSAT approved national center, and also Szentendre University, the center for the genetic endocrine tumor syndromes. Here at this university, there is a centralized biobanking service, and also the Szentendre University is a coordinator of the national Hungarian node for DBMRI. Centralized laboratory and centralized imaging system are also available, which for the further activities, it's very important because there is a unique database containing all these relevant patient reports. A few words about the National Institute of Oncology. Here, 2 departments are dealing with genetics. The department have myself, the Department of Molecular Genetics, are dealing with germline mutation screening. We are covering all kind of hereditary cancers. So we are doing all, I would say, all hereditary cancer gene testing here. And the Department of Surgical Pathology are doing the complex molecular genetic analysis for solid tumors. Also, we are members of ELOCAN and we plan to work with the genetics. Centralized biobanking service, laboratory diagnostic and imaging system also available here. Going further from Budapest, the 3 regional centers, University of Pécs, I have to mention here because not only because it's a very big center, but also there is a department of medical genetics head now by Dr. Hajzer, but the former head professor Béla Meleg, you may know him, he was the bigger professor who started actually the genetic medicine there, and that department is the longest I think in Hungary. Also, University of Pécs participates in ERMs, and here another very important facility, the Bioinformatics Research Group, and this is a very promising facility. Here will be, as I know, in Hungary, the first Novasec system. So this facility, we are looking forward working with them, and I think majority of our 1 million genome workload will be done here, and the group is already there. They are good expertise in bioinformatics and also in data management. University of Debrecen and University of Szeged are mainly doing the clinical genetics work. They are division for rare diseases or department of clinical genetics. And also they are, as you see here, they are also participating in different ERMs. They each university has their own main focus. Here the liver and metabolism, while in Szeged the skin and the heart disease are the main focus. In all these universities, the centralized laboratory diagnostics and centralized patient care system, medical information system are available. Going further, what are the challenges for genetic diseases here? We face every day that the clinical genetics, the workload and the patient care by clinical geneticists are well organized, I would say, in Hungary. So there is an opportunity to go and to be the patient evaluated and examined by high qualified geneticists. But the genetic laboratory diagnostics is very challenging, and here we have several molecular genetic laboratories with various capacities and workflows. It's very important to highlight here that all these interventions are financed by the National Insurance Service. So all diagnostic activities is covered by Hungarian insurance. Of course, there exists some private laboratory which offer various testing capacities, and unfortunately, the general population sometimes it's skeptical with our activities, and they turn their interest to the private laboratory. Of course, we cannot do anything, everything. So some genetic tests are performed abroad using the centralized providers. But I have to mention again that all these genetic tests performed abroad are financed by National Health Insurance based on individual requests. It's very important that it's well organized now that these applications are formally and technically and expert and are reviewed by real expert panels. Two expert panels are existing. One is dedicated for genetic diseases and disorders. This is covered by members of Board of Clinical Genetics, while for oncology, for cancer, targeted treatment in oncology, these requests are approved by National Molecular Oncology. So these two big organizations are working hard with the National Health Insurance Fund in Hungary in order to at least provide the necessary activities and also to have a professional control of about on these activities. So now a few words about our current needs and challenges. As I said earlier, and I saw today that not only in Hungary but in other countries too, is the most important thing I would say, the education of healthcare providers, and also to share the knowledge in general population, because without them, without the information, without the knowledge, and we are doing our best, the output would be the same. So this is the very important, I would say, the education and different levels and using mass media, using newspapers, everything. So I would focus on this as well. We have short-term goals, which I think can be solved relatively easily through the Hungarian Society of Human Genetics and Genomics, and also through professional collaborations. We need to update our national rare disease registry. We need to develop a new web-based registry about the available genetic test possibilities in Hungary, and also about the ongoing research and training programs focusing on rare diseases. What we are expecting from the 1 million genome project. So first, and I'm very happy that best practices related to developing and maintaining registries, and also to have the data quality and other controlled and suggested algorithms which is under development through this program. So we are looking forward to using these best practices in our everyday practice. Of course, another important issue, the financial model for covering expenses related to genetic testing and gene therapies. And very important, we try to build a national reference genome database. And it's important for healthcare, but also it's very important for ongoing research projects. There in Hungary, these data are available in an investigator-related manner. So it means that genetic data, whole genome data, whole exome data are available at universities, at various PIs. So we have to deal with data sharing and build this database combining various from the results from various outputs. So we have very challenging situation with the already existing data. Of course, we did the first step, and the whole national media group has been formed. Professional geneticists and molecular geneticists are present here. Myself, Professor Molnár, Professor Meleg, and also we are lucky that Professor Kovács, who is a bioethics professor in bioethics, it's involved in our everyday work. Also, we have a support from Ministry of Human Capacities, and two informaticians are involved also. I mentioned already Attila Zenesei, who is also the head of the Elixir in Hungary, Elixir Hub, so he's a real expert in bioinformatics, and also my colleague from the National Institute of Oncology, Bognár Pál, is a web database manager and informatics informatician working in this field. Next step and our future plans are summarized here. So we have to make sequencing platforms available in Hungary. Also, we have to map and to collect the data already existing, available exons or whole genomes. We need to do a shareable database and develop a national database where we can share our data. Also, we have to provide input for our government to indicate the real need for sequencing of 6,500 genomes. And based on the UK experience, which I followed months ago, in Hungary, we think that 3 or 4 national hubs will be enough to complete our need. Of course, these hubs should be equipped with sequencing platform, bioinformatics, clinical and medical geneticists. The second, we would like to implement the best practices suggested by this current project. And also, we would like to provide input for developers of the national database using everyday healthcare. We have a unified system online available, and in order to incorporate the genetic data into this platform. So of course, we have to deal with recent guidelines and legislative ethical issues. So it's a very complex task. And I think this is what we are now. Thank you very much.